Denver Wine Radio with Paul Bonacquisti and Cha-Cha Chavez. Presented by Bonacquisti Wine Company and Cha's Back in the Day Cafe.
Son of a gun is 12:01 in the Mile High City. We're on like Donkey Kong.
I haven't heard that in years.
That's a tribute to our friend JoJo.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. How are you? Good morning, Paul.
Good morning, Cha.
Good afternoon.
Welcome to Denver Wine Radio. What a great day in the Mile High City.
It's a little breezy.
It is a little breezy, but, Saturdays at noon, made for wine tasting.
Absolutely.
And that's what it's all about.
We're going to uncork it.
We are going to uncork it. Today on the show, we're going to do Chardonnay.
Okay.
And our special guest in studio is Kyle Schlachter from the Colorado Wine Industry Development Board. How's it going, Kyle?
Doing well. How are you doing, Paul? Thanks for having me.
Good morning, Kyle.
Yeah. Good morning.
Glad to have you here. Wow. Hey.
Well, you got sound effects and everything.
How come I didn't get a ding dong?
Thank you.
Love it. Thank you. Hey, funny. So Kyle's the outreach coordinator for the Colorado Wine Board and does a lot of great work over there. And also, he's on the Littleton City Council.
Right on.
Yeah, yeah.
And he has a wine blog called Colorado Wine Press. He writes about wine. He's really kick-ass. I can say that.
Yeah, it's a little neglected right now. I haven't been writing as much as I used to, but it's fun.
You look really, really young to have like all this experience in drinking the vino, dude.
I got started early.
And your bottle?
Well, yeah. Yeah, and then and of course, check it out. He was featured in Wine Enthusiast magazine.
Ooh, that's a big one right there.
40 under 40.
Dude.
Tasters.
Yeah, that was fun. That was I was surprised about that.
That's the Rolling Stone of wine.
It is. It is, really, yeah.
Yeah, it is. That's the Rolling Stone of wine. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you
awesome.
Very much. Yeah, it was
That's
fun. Awesome. Last year, I went out though to San Francisco and had a photo shoot. There were a bunch of other people
wow.
out there, so that was fun.
See? Big time now. Oh, photo yeah. shoots and everything, Polly. That's awesome.
I'm kind of a big deal.
Yeah, I love it.
Our producer's on fire today.
Yeah, that was good. That was
with
good.
The drops. I love that. That was funny.
Yeah, so... So talk about 40 under 40. That's really a cool thing. And how'd that come about?
Did you get nominated
or what?
Yeah, I got nominated. I think the producer or the editors for Wine Enthusiast sit down. They get a big meeting and they kind of go through every year. They have a 40 under 40 issue and they try to find younger people in the wine industry. And I worked with a couple of the writers, a couple of the editors a year back on an article about Colorado. And they put my name forward and they said, hey, you're out there promoting a underappreciated wine region, and they said
Absolutely.
We really like what you're doing, and they put me in that. I was quite surprised
right
when I got
on.
The email. I thought it was a scam.
Oh, you did?
I'm like, oh no, this isn't right. Someone's trying to trick me here.
Right?
But, no, yeah, it was fun.
So tell us a little bit about yourself. How did you get into this? Are you from Colorado?
No, I'm originally from Wisconsin. I came out here about 20 years ago to college, and my background's in geography. But in college, I started tasting some wine, and I it just blew me away how connected wine is to geography. How you can have
You need to explain Lucy.
There's different ways to explain that. Is you take the same grape, you take Chardonnay today. Mm-hmm. We have a whole bunch of different Chardonnays on the table, all the same grape, but they're going to taste wildly different just based on the place they're grown.
Right on.
And you can have two Chardonnays right next to each other and taste wildly different just because the soils are different, just mm-hmm. because the water is mm-hmm. a little bit different
Absolutely.
There. So it's just fascinating. And then you get to see different regions in the world that produce different grapes. So if you go to France, all the regions in France are based on the types of grapes they grow there. And so you go from Bordeaux to Burgundy to Loire Valley, and it's based on the grape. So the geography, I really like to think of wine as geography in a bottle.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, I like that. Geography in a bottle.
I like that.
So I just explored explore geography through wine.
Right on. What country are we going to today?
Well, we're going to start here in Colorado.
All right, let's go.
Because we've got a couple of Chardonnays from the Western Slope. We brought in Two Rivers Chardonnay and also brought in Plum Creek Chardonnay.
Okay.
And both of those are two wineries that have been around a long time in Colorado.
And Chardonnay, is it a little sweeter? Is it a little sweeter wine?
It tends to be drier. It depends on the style. There's Chardonnay is a big spectrum of styles. You can have real light, almost steely, acidic Chardonnays, or you can have, in California, oftentimes you have these big, rich, buttery Chardonnays.
Oh. Mm-hmm. Mm.
Yeah, and then hotter, you know, hotter climate, warmer climates can drive more tropical fruit profiles to them. Cooler climates, you'll have more crisp acidity and more citrusy type profiles. So
yeah, you'll taste anything from green apples to pears to coconut.
Coconuts.
Coconut. Yeah.
What?
That's the effect of oak barrels.
And let me tell you,
coconuts.
Yeah, coconut.
Mm-hmm.
Huh.
So Chardonnay. Let me just tell you is probably the top planted grape in the world, don't you think? Or
it's up there.
It's up there. In the top couple, two or three. And when I was out shopping for Chardonnay last night, there was a Chardonnay section. I went over to Molly's and I was just in the it was basically California. They probably had, I don't know, 75 to 100 different California Chardonnays.
Wow.
And, then I went over to the Burgundy section to grab the French Chardonnay that we're going to try. And I didn't even touch, of course, I grabbed the two Colorado wines there as well. But I didn't even touch on like Australia, any of the other regions around the world. So there's...
Wow.
So you can easily get overwhelmed with trying to just pick out a Chardonnay.
Yeah, there's Chardonnay planted pretty much in every wine region in the world.
Wow.
Yeah.
Interesting.
And it grows really well here in Colorado. It's been around. It's probably, the top two?
It's the top white.
Oh, it is the top white in Colorado.
It goes back and forth between, you got Merlot, Cabernet Sauvignon, Riesling and Chardonnay go back and forth. But, it's one of the top three or four grapes planted in Colorado.
Well, I'm anxious to taste.
Oh, well, then that's my cue, I guess, to open up a bottle of wine. So we should probably start... I don't really have a clue today, but I'm going to start with one of the twisties, okay?
That's easy, yeah.
That'll save us some time. And so I'm starting with the Two Rivers Chardonnay. This is 2015 Mesa County. So Mesa County the county that is Palisade, right?
Yeah, Palisade, Grand Junction, all in Mesa County.
Okay.
And so when you look at a wine label... it usually says where the grapes were grown. And in this case, it says Mesa County. You can look at the country. It can say American. It can go to the state. It could say Colorado. You can go down to the county, or you can keep getting more specific down into what we call the Appalachian or the American viticultural area. And we have two of those in Colorado. One's called the Grand Valley ABA.
Where's that?
That's over around Grand Junction Palisade.
Okay.
And then there's the West Elks ABA. And that's kind of by Hotchkiss and Paonia, about an hour, 90 minutes southeast of Grand Junction.
Huh.
Yeah.
I have to pack up the RV and go to these places. Seriously, Polly. I have to tell you, my friend bought an RV.
Oh
yeah.
I got to hear about that.
We're getting it ready for the road trip. We could do a wine tasting RV party.
All right. So,
you know, it's.
What's the first thing you smell, Chaw?
The first thing I smell is like fruity, like a. Some kind of a fruit, like a peachy almost, kind of.
Yeah, I get some peach. You got some apricot. I get a little almost baked apples.
Yeah, I get
apple pie.
Yeah, totally. Let me see. Ooh, that's nice. It's very smooth. That's not me, everybody. They're making sounds.
How many people have heard their friends or your parents make a noise like that when they're drinking wine? Have you ever heard that before?
Mm-mm, never. I was like, what are you doing over there? It's like swishing or what?
Please excuse yourself.
So that's to bring oxygen into your mouth, and it adds the flavors as you taste it. So you do that.
And what were you doing?
Basically just breathing in.
Sometimes that helps. So there's real no... Now, you don't spit that wine out on that microphone.
So, this is very good. I like this. Very good.
There's no real, there's no wrong way or right way. I mean, but if you want to agitate it in your mouth, suck a little air in, you know, and that helps you release some more flavors in your mouth, yeah, go for it.
Oh, it's really
good.
That's
how he does it. All right.
This with a really good, like, fish like salmon or something. Would be
yeah, that'd be good.
I'd pair that up with that.
Yeah, chicken fajitas.
Oh, are
always
you,
that's what
fajitas?
I go. I go to.
Okay, so, chicken fajitas. Okay.
All right, we're tasting right Chardonnay on. Today on Denver Wine Radio, and when we come back, we're gonna dive into some more wine and see what else Cha tastes. You're listening to Denver Wine Radio on Mile High Sports.